AT from CNC at home. Something caught my eye in my working area. It was one of the coasters, and just out of the corner of my eye, I saw something different than what was on it. For some reason, what I saw were some characters from the TV show MASH. That's not what was on it. I don't even remember what was on it. Doesn't really matter. It gave me the idea to make a MASH coaster. It was a staple of my growing up, one of my favorite shows, and it should make a great coaster. I went online, did some searching, found a couple images that I want to try. Let's start by opening up the template for a coaster. Here's the first image that I wanted to try. Let's zoom in on that. Oh, that's going to potentially be an issue. It's very pixelated, so that's probably not going to do so well as a coaster. I liked this picture. This was more of the original cast where we've got Trapper John and Radar on there and Colonel Blake. So I don't think this is going to work so well. It's just too low of resolution. What I can do is I can grab the word MASH off of this. Let's go ahead and right-click the image and there we go. Right-click the image and do a trace on that. And it looks like it's picked up everything for the most part, maybe just a little more. Or a little less. No, that was pretty good where it started out. We'll go with that. It's going to get the whole image, and we'll just delete some of that. So most of this stuff we don't need. I just want this part where it says MASH. So let's first ungroup that and start deleting some of these pieces that we don't need. Don't need all of that. This is the part that I want. I'll go ahead and group that together so this stays as one piece. I guess I should have opened my template first. I'll just do a square here. I'll just use the square tool and press the shift key to make it an actual square. I'll put that on my tool one layer and change its size to 109 millimeters. And just push that down into the lower corner. This will get to, we'll need this down here at some point too. I have another image that I liked. Let's bring that one in. Hopefully this has got some better resolution. All right, this image looks quite a bit better. We zoom in, it's a much higher resolution image. It's the wrong form factor. It's very wide, and we want it to fit on our coaster. So we're going to have to do some cropping, or we're going to lose some of the image, that sort of thing. So let's just shrink it down a little bit and bring it down here. And let's just zoom in so we can see all of this. And I'm going to move my tool layer down so that it's underneath or on top, essentially, of the picture so I can see what I'm working with. All right, let's do this as well. Since it's going to be wider than my coaster, let's go ahead and select the image. Then I'm going to do a shift select of my tool layer, right click, and apply mask. And what that'll do is it'll essentially crop my image to my coaster template. All right, so let's get this moved up a little bit. Something like that. Maybe move it over. Maybe make it just a little smaller so I can get a little more of the image on there. There, something more like that. Doesn't look too bad. And we'll take our MASH logo and we'll put it just above here. And then I'm going to shift select my template again and get that centered. Oh, that was pretty close. Oh, that doesn't look too bad. Let's do a quick preview. Here's a preview of that. It looks a little backwards for some reason. What's going on? Yeah, for some reason, the inverse is on. We don't want that. Now our preview looks more correct. The problem is it's very dark. We don't really see much of the background. I'm going to lighten this up a little bit. So make sure that my image is selected. Come over to Shape Properties. And let's just brighten this up a little bit, maybe 15%. It certainly looks bright here. Let's do a preview. That looks much better. We can see our actors' faces much better, and we see a little bit of the background as well. I think this will work pretty well. So in my cut layers, we have our... If I right-click on that, here's our word mash. Let's go to the library. I'm going to cut this out on a titanium dioxide, so let's go ahead and select fill. I'll just click assign and assign that to the layer. And then for the image, we'll do the same thing. I will select my image from my library and assign that. All I need to do now is save this and send it over to the laser. If you like this video, think about giving it a thumbs up or a salute. We have the tile in position, the laser focused. I'm going to do a quick frame to make sure that the burn is going to happen on the coaster. That looked really good. Let's go ahead and get the exhaust fan started and we can get this burn going. We'll move the gantry out of the way and take a look at what this looks like. Not too bad. There's some lines in here. I don't know if you can see that or not. Horizontal streaking in here. I don't know if that has to do with an error in burning or if there was something with the application, the titanium dioxide. I'm thinking I will try another tile and see if it does the same thing. Okay, let's take a look at this one. It appears that it has turned out quite a bit better. Let me spin that around. Oh yeah, that looks quite a bit better. I don't know what happened to the previous one, but this one looks a lot better. I'll go get that cleaned up and take a look at it. Now, I saw this on the other one, right here. I thought there were scratches in the titanium dioxide, but this has the exact same pattern. And looking at the image, that's just a bright spot on the image. So it's supposed to be there. Let's go clean it up. That turned out very well. I'm pleased with how this second one turned out. I don't know what happened to the first one. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.
Oops.